Guys, and welcome to my channel. In this video, we're going to be talking about the B word, and that B word is betrayal. Because after narcissistic abuse, when the dust settles, we are going to be left feeling betrayed, guys. So let's talk about that. Why are we feeling betrayed? It's pretty obvious. We invited someone into our personal space. We believed they cared about us, and we find out it was all fake and phony, and just them toying and playing with our emotion, our times, our research, our resources, our hearts, bodies, souls, and spirits, just to get supply of whatever they wanted. And then they either tossed us to the side, or we had to remove ourselves from that toxicness. And either way, it just left us with this horrible stench because we saw the best in someone. We believed the best in someone. We tried to love someone. We tried to care and give to someone. And what were we rewarded with? A knife in the back. And not only do they usually put those knives in our backs and then they twist it around as many times as they can, and it's like they're getting joy out of it as well. So we're betrayed at that point, rightfully so, to feel that way. But we need to learn how to manage this feeling. And I do say manage because this is a traumatic experience. Oftentimes, dealing with a narcissist is a traumatic experience for the survivor. So if we're dealing with a trauma, it will be a lifelong journey of healing for us, with our ups and downs and highs and lows. The only thing is, if you do the proper work, you shouldn't be feeling like the first day of rock bottom. Those feelings will be far in between as we further in our healing journey, but there will be days where we remember, are we recalling what has happened, and we're going to feel some kind of way. Because people have these misconceptions about what healing actually looks like. It doesn't mean that we never forget, remember. It doesn't mean that we don't feel things. We will. Just with more healing, it will become less potent, but it will always bother you on some level. And that's why it's going to be a lifelong healing process. And sometimes we could be triggered, and sometimes we have really rough days and day, moment, hour, whatever, and it could be years later. It happens. So let's be prepared for those feelings. But right now, let's just dive into betrayal. I made a list here of things that I would like to present to you guys that might help you in managing this feeling of betrayal, okay? The first thing is considering the source. We're dealing with a narcissist, and unfortunately, they did the best they could do. This is what they do to everybody, and this is a cycle. So all of the betrayal, the lies, the games, the manipulation, this was their best foot forward. And it doesn't excuse what they did. It doesn't make what they did right, but it just speaking to this person's character and their capabilities. All right, it's not letting them off the hook, but it's just saying, look at what we're dealing with here. Look at the source. This person with low moral compass wasn't gonna miraculously come on this high moral compass. And if they did, it was very fake and temporary. You know, nothing that they could do prolong. Just something to try to, yet again, manipulate someone. So let's consider the source, guys. They're doing it to somebody else right now. All right. The next thing that I have on here is faith. I don't actually know how I would have dealt with this situation if I didn't have a faith in my life. I do believe in a God, and I've had to call on Him. I've lost count of how many times, with tears rolling down my cheeks in the thick of my hurt and my pain of feeling this betrayal, and just, God, help me, bring me peace, help me understand this. Like, I don't want to feel rage. I don't want to feel these things. Can you help bring peace into my life? I've had to call on my God for that. And if you believe in a God, I highly recommend that you do that as well. It's been an excellent source to me, and I'm constantly praying on it, even to this day when I have my flashbacks or I have my days and moments and times where I'm feeling this deep injustice about things, I have to lean on my God. Okay? And the next thing that I want to say is to step outside of yourself. And I know I don't want to lessen what anyone is feeling or going through, because it's very valid. And I'm going to talk about validating yourself next. But sometimes we have to step outside of ourselves to prevent us from moping, basically. And also to give us a broader sense of things. We're not promised a fair life. I'm sorry, but we're just not. It's not fun or happy to think about that, but it's a reality. And when we step outside of ourselves and we think of all of the pain and misery that has happened to plenty of people in this world, in this life, and that will happen in the future, that's already happened, that's presently happened, we know that we're not alone in our pain and suffering. And as we see in a narcissistic community, there's so many of us survivors. So it wasn't this isolated thing that just only happened to you. A lot of people have suffered and experienced this. And some people get comfort from knowing that they're not alone. And then they can, you know, connect themselves with the community such as this and get validation and get comfort from others. It's helpful in dealing with that betrayal feeling, okay? The next thing I want to say is acknowledge your feelings. Now isn't the time to pretend like things never happen or to be in any type of denial that will only stunt your healing process. We need to keep it real with ourselves and see things for exactly what happened. And find ways to validate yourself, because I know that the narcissist has, you know, more than likely assassined our character and smeared our names to the people that they know or that they need to continue to buy their stories, you know? And that also adds to the betrayal. And it's like, are you kidding me? This person gets to do all this stuff to me, and now they get to then go lie on me to other people and have other people convinced that I was the problem, that I was the abuser? Like, where does the unfairness stop? And this is a big part of the betrayal here. Now, for me, I'm not going to use this video to get into my specifics, because the betrayal in itself is not the topic of the video, but just healing from the betrayal. But I'm going to say that I use writing. Writing was very therapeutic for me, by the way, but it was the tool that I used to get myself to be heard, because I wanted my truth to be heard, so I decided to write about it. And that's been very helpful to me. And it might help you too, even if you don't decide to publish a book. Get your laptop out and start typing about what happened so that you can feel heard. Some people come on to my videos and they tell their story. They email me. Get a notepad, a pencil, a paper, and start writing it down. It's actually a form of a release when you're writing this stuff down. It's like releasing your emotions, and it's something that you just have to experience for yourself. And, you know, some people might even write poetry about how they were feeling. Like, you can find creative ways to do this, or going to counseling. That's a great way to talk about it and to feel like you've been voicing yourself. Or if you have a confidant or someone close in your family that you can confide in. It's very important to acknowledge our feelings and not bottle them down to help us move past this betrayal. Okay, the next thing that I'm going to talk about in as far as betrayal with narcissistic abuse is it's usually a double-edged sword, because the narcissist has betrayed us, and then there are levels of betrayal that we've done to ourselves. And this is what may be hard for a lot of people to heal from, because we're being so hard on ourselves. People are usually most hard on themselves. They really are. Even the narcissists, we think they're hard on us. They're even harder on themselves. That's why they can't even present their true selves to anyone. They keep that person hidden because that person isn't good enough to them. This isn't about them. This is about us. We may have betrayed ourselves by not upholding our boundaries the way that we needed to, and having our confidence to let go of this person when we knew a little while ago, you know, to keep taking the bait and keep allowing that cycle. You know, there are ways that we violated ourselves as well. Okay, guys? The other thing I want to say in here is to work on forgiveness. And the forgiveness is not because the narcissist deserves it, but because we deserve our inner peace, because that's what we really want out of this whole feeling of betrayal. We want our peace back. We don't feel at peace. So we have to forgive ourselves for how we betrayed ourselves in the ways that we betrayed ourselves, and forgive the narcissist as well. And forgiving them doesn't mean that they were right. It just means that I'm not going to give it a certain amount of power over me. I'm working to move past this situation so that I can have a certain kind of healing that would help me reconnect with my peace. Okay? And there's a cute little quote that I found. And the quote is, "The highest spiritual practice is to bear insult without returning it." So when I hear that quote, and the quote is by Sarvananda Sarawati, I'll leave her name in the quotes in case I just totally destroyed it. But when I hear that quote in regards to betrayal, I'm feeling like we can take that betrayal without adding to the saga of trying to betray this narcissist back. Because trust me, they're betraying themselves every waking day of their life. They really are. The next thing that I want to have on here to share with you guys is to remove yourself from the betrayal. Like, how can we begin our healing when we're still immersed and connected to the betrayal, so to speak? That means we're still in a relationship with them. They're still laying in a bed next to us. I don't see how healing is going to start, because we're actually still interacting with our betrayer, you know? Those bridges are burnt, never to be crossed again. All right, so as long as we're still in that cycle, don't count on healing to be happening for you. All right, the next thing that I have on here is to have lots of self-care and self-love. You know, we've betrayed ourselves enough in the moments that we did with the narcissist. Now it's time to love ourselves. You know, when we're feeling this lack of peace and all this emotional pain, and it's disrupted ourselves, and we're maybe feeling revengeful, we're just crushed, we're hurt, we're pissed off, we're all these things balled into one. Now is the time to be very gentle to ourselves, to practice lots of self-love and self-care. All the things that we were willing to go out of the way to do for the narcissist, let's turn that inward now and do all those things for ourselves. We need to be able to do that and then some. We shouldn't be giving anybody else more love and care than we would give for ourselves. We're not last on the list anymore. We're first. Because we can't pour from an empty cup. How can we give love to other people if we don't love ourselves first? It's very true. It's a cliche that we hear all the time, but it's very, very true. If we're not actually loving ourselves, we can't be loving other people. We can't. We can't. We can mimic. We can be doing things that look like love, which is what the narcissist does to us. They're mirroring what they've observed love should be like, or what it should be like in their mind, but it's not genuine and it's not sincere, because it's not actually love. And that's why they can't actually maintain it, and their actions aren't in alignment with it, because they say one thing and they do another. Okay, so we have to have that self-love for ourselves, real self-love. Okay. Also, I wanted to point out with betrayal that it's usually an invitation for us to experience growth in our life. You know, think about the areas that the narcissist exploited with you. The betrayal has shined a light on those areas, and they may typically be areas that we need to work on within ourselves so that someone else can't then come along and exploit us for that. So betrayal is an invitation, guys. So accept the invitation, and being as though you're here on my channel, it looks like you are trying to at least accept the invitation. And that's a good thing. And it's actually a positive spin on this whole thing, and that is the invitation to become stronger and better people. Okay? Let's see. The other thing I have on my list is to take a leap of faith. What does that mean? That means that to not let the whole situation jade you into thinking that, you know, everyone's going to betray you, because this can happen. Someone give us one good time. It's like, I ain't never being nice to nobody again. I ain't never being kind to a stranger again. I ain't going to never, you know. It puts us in that state of putting up that really big brick wall. But what happens is not only do the bad people get blocked out, the good people get blocked out too. And we don't want to do that, because then we start blocking our blessings. We're blocking our blessings when that happens. So we're going to have to take the situation from the betrayal and learn from it, so that we'll be wiser and discerning moving forward, what we should and shouldn't be doing, who we should and shouldn't be allowing into our lives. Okay? Let's see, what else do I have on here? All right, we talked about that already. All right, yeah. All right, looks like I pretty much covered the things that I had on my list here. And, you know, I really hope that it helps you guys. But, you know, I understand, you know, how it feels to the core. I understand. But, you know, like I said, we can become better at managing this feeling of betrayal, and it won't always hurt like it did on day one, okay? It won't always hurt. Like right now, I am like so far away from where I used to be, and I used to have panic attacks. I had post-traumatic stress disorder. I was in counseling. Oh my gosh, it really did a number on me. Because honestly, it was what that last narcissist did and all the other ones did and all the other things that I went through. It was all piled up on top of each other, and I finally had to just unpack all of it and deal with all the betrayals and really get myself to where I am right now. And as you can see, you know, I'm sincerely standing here and smiling and glowing. I don't even got on any makeup in this video, honey. Like, you know, I'm in a much better place. You know, I have the panic attacks, haven't had them in over a year, and I'm just in a better place. But I did that work, and I felt the pain. And sometimes I still get triggered, and I have my moments and days and times, but I'm already aware for that. I allow myself to have that space and time, and I don't judge myself for it. When I feel it coming, I acknowledge it, and I deal with it. And then on those days, I'm extra, extra gentle with myself. And whatever I can do to make myself happy, I do it. And lots and lots of prayer. Lots of prayer for me. Calling out to my God. Yes, I do it. So I hope that these things have helped you guys in dealing with betrayal. Like, it's a sucky part of human existence. But, you know, we can take that situation and turn it into a more positive light. We really can. We really can if we choose to. You just have to make that choice, guys. Your life is not over. You can recover from this. And I understand the bitterness and the pain and the injustice that you were feeling on the inside of you. I understand. And you're not alone. You're not alone. Okay? So if this video resonates with you, go ahead and hit the like button. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. I do upload videos quite frequently. There's a great playlist that you can check right now. Lots of information there to help you out. And you feel free to share any and all of my videos. And for all of you that have been rocking out with me, thank you. I really appreciate it. And just be blessed, be safe, and be well. And until next video, take care.